Bonnie Raitt joins Bruce Springsteen and Jackson Browne tonight and tomorrow night at the Shrine Auditorium. It's an all-acoustic benefit concert for the Christic Institute, a Santa Monica-based public interest group. Life gets my precious when there's less of it to wait. Some good news and some bad news about that concert. The good news, we're told that some tickets are still available. The bad news, they're priced at $500. Aww. Since it is a benefit, it is tax deductible.
Stars in the music business are gathering at Shrine Auditorium right now, and that's where John is. What's coming up?
Well, I'll tell you, Jerry. As a matter of fact, Jackson Browne is performing on stage. It's a fundraiser for the Christic Institute, and of course, they're trying to publicize what that organization is, but everybody wants to know what the boss will sing tonight, and also what Bonnie Raitt said about Milli Vanilli. We'll have it coming up.
Springsteen, Jackson Browne, Bonnie Raitt together on stage tonight performing in a benefit concert. John Corcoran has all of the excitement live from the Shrine Auditorium. Well, you're out and among some big ones tonight there.
Oh, yeah, there's some real stars here, and yeah. I think you can hear in the background, it's supposed to be an acoustic concert, which means no electricity, but as Jackson Browne said earlier today, drums are kind of acoustic, so you can count those among them. Yes, Jackson Browne is on stage performing right now. Bonnie Raitt will follow him, and then a long-awaited reappearance on stage of Bruce Springsteen. The big question is, who will be playing with Bruce? According to the program, maybe nobody. It might be just Bruce and his acoustic guitar. We had a chance to talk backstage. Very brief interviews, as a matter of fact. Jackson Browne and Bonnie Raitt together. They talked a little bit about the Christic Institute. We'll have more on that at 10. But also, they talked about some items in the news. And here is that interview now.
Okay, we're down to 45 seconds, so let's get into the music area. What are you going to do tonight, Jackson?
Well, this is an acoustic concert, and it's real interesting to see what everybody's version of acoustic music is.
Yeah.
You know, 'cause after all, drums are acoustic instruments.
Yeah.
I mean, what is acoustic? Basically, without telling you what everybody's going to do, it's going to be a really nice spectrum between playing completely alone and playing with a few tasty musicians.
What does Bruce mean to this thing tonight? Oh, first of all, what are you going to play tonight, Bonnie? And what does Bruce mean to this thing?
I think all of us are going to be doing acoustic versions of our hits, and some of us have more of those than others. But we're going to be doing some things together, and it'll be a much more intimate version for the audience and for us. So it's really kind of a closing in on, focusing in on these songs. And I'm going to be doing some of the more quiet stuff, although, you know, some of the things from Nick of Time.
I heard a terrible rumor outside that you two actually did the songs for Milli Vanilli. Any truth to that?
You know, we couldn't get our hair right. That they wouldn't loan us their wigs. I don't know.
What do you think about that? Should they take back their Grammy?
I don't know.
We don't know the case?
About
I don't know either. They've been asking us. Who we are trying to...
Another reporter asked them something about...
We're doing a concert for peace and justice, and we're talking about something that's irrelevant, so I really couldn't care less.
Isn't it awful? That's the way news is sometimes. It's just irrelevant.
People that sing should sing, and people that don't sing should get out of the business.
Okay, Milli Vanilli, they might be talking about you. That's Bonnie Raitt, who, of course, won 4 Grammys herself, saying, if you sing, sing. If not, get out of the business. This is Jackson Browne, recorded a little bit earlier. He is on stage performing acoustically. Bonnie Raitt, as we said, will be performing a little bit later. And then The Boss, sometime around 10. Give a listen. Okay, that, of course, Jackson Browne performing on stage now at the Shrine Auditorium, Bonnie Raitt later, and then, of course, The Boss. And everybody wants to know what he will be doing, if he'll be doing any new songs. So far, nobody has heard that his band will be with him. He has pretty much dropped the E Street Band and will be performing acoustic tonight, first performance in 2 years. Of course, the Christic Institute, some people call it a liberal think tank. It is an organization very close to the hearts of these performers. We'll have more about that at 10 o'clock, and hopefully music from The Boss. Back at 10.
Okay. We know, of course, the great musical talent of Bonnie Raitt, but what a wonderful way she has with words, as per your interview.
Yeah, she said it like it was.
Born in the USA, got in a little They're here for a benefit concert at the Shrine. Our own John Corcoran is standing by with the scoop.
Hey.
Hey, John.
Oh, live television. Honest to goodness, sometimes it can be so cruel. We saw Jackson Browne sing, did a nice acoustic set. Bonnie Raitt, just sensational. Then Jackson joined her on stage. Then they had intermission, and 1 minute ago, I'm not kidding, Bruce started saying, I'm going to go. No, I guess I really need to report and tell you what's happening, but we'd like to hear him sing. He's doing brilliant disguise. He's doing it solo. This is the first performance by Bruce Springsteen in a couple of years, 2 years to be exact, and he's doing it for a good cause, the Christic Institute, which has been involved in a lot of good causes, such things as Iran-Contra, supplying money and attorneys for people suing the government, etc. Jackson Browne, Bonnie Raitt, we talked to him earlier and heard him play. Give a listen.
I'm optimistic that the court, which is that the case, which is in appeals, will go forward. That the appeal will be granted, and that the appeal will win, and that the case will be in go to trial.
We're going to be doing acoustic versions of our hits, and some of us have more of those than others, but and we're going to be doing some things together, and it'll be a much more intimate version for the audience and for us.
Okay, live television sometimes can be good. We have it in the truck, tape of Bruce singing. Hit it, Joel.
I hold you in my arms as the band plays. What are those words whispered, baby, just as you turn away? I saw you last night out on the edge of town. I wanna read your mind and know just what I've got in this new thing I found.
We have the finest cruise in the history of show business. Believe me, Bruce Springsteen, not 15 seconds ago, was singing, and we got him on the track, and we're so proud. It's for the Christic Institute. It's going on here. It's also tomorrow night. The place was packed, 6,000 strong. Tickets running from $25 to, up to $500 in some cases for the Golden Circle. So they're going to make $500,000 to $1 million in all likelihood in the next couple of nights. And we got to see Bruce live, and I'm happy to hear that. Back to you guys.
Bring back some of those Golden Circle tickets for us, would you, John?
Right.
Intimate benefit concert with three musical legends by name, Bonnie Raitt, Jackson Browne, and Bruce Springsteen. And Francesca Cappucci will tell you all about it. Bonnie Raitt, Jackson Browne, and Bruce Springsteen joined forces tonight in support of the Christic Institute. It is a Washington-based public interest law and policy center, best known for its in-depth investigations and public education. The center won the Karen Silkwood case and is currently involved in the La Penca lawsuit, which surrounds the illegal funding of the Contra War. Bonnie Raitt and Jackson Browne are no newcomers to benefit concerts. But you have always been very passionate about causes throughout your career, and so this is nothing...
Not causes. About justice. About one thing, about justice, about fairness, and about truth.
Yeah, I mean, they're all related, and the fact that we things are being done in our name that they're trying to withhold information about is just not American. We're going to keep nailing them, you know what I'm saying? Not going to get away with it.
And Bruce Springsteen made his last public appearance with the Amnesty International tour in 1988. Bonnie, Jackson, and Bruce will perform here at the Shrine Auditorium again tomorrow night in hopes of raising $500,000 for the Christic Institute. In Los Angeles, Francesca Cappucci, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.
Thank you, Frankie. That's a hot ticket.
Live report. Neri, how's it sound?
Jim, well, I'm going to find out very shortly. We've got about 5,000 people here getting a real treat tonight. We have Bruce Springsteen entertaining them right now on the stage. And we've also heard from Jackson Browne and also from Bonnie Raitt. And as I said, I plan to be in there very soon. All of them got together tonight to help a center that's trying to further the Iran-Contra investigation. Music was sweet and soothing, but the cause behind the concert very serious. Jackson Browne, Bonnie Raitt, and Bruce Springsteen teaming up for the Christic Institute, a nonprofit center for law and public policy. Its most prominent current pursuit, getting to the bottom of the Iran-Contra affair, and the musical stars are putting their weight behind it.
What it amounts to is it's uncovered a level of corruption that is all pervasive, that is all through higher reaches of government, and that has resulted in a kind of loss of our rights as Americans.
As long as I have a voice left, we're gonna keep nailing them, you know what I'm saying? Not gonna get away with it.
Officials estimate tonight's concert will raise about $1 million for their cause. Jim Penny, back to you.
All right, thanks very much, Neary.
For tonight, we sure thank you for being with us.
And before we ask you to stay tuned for America Tonight with Robert Krulwich and Edie Magnus, we have one more final treat for you.
That's right. We're going to take another look at that special concert at the Shrine Auditorium where the boss is taking the stage. Have
Yours,
a great
boss.
Weekend.
I hold you in my arms. Here's a band plays. What are those words whispered, baby? Just as you turn away, I saw you last night out on the edge of town. I wanna read your mind and know just what I've got in this new thing I found. So tell me what I see when I look in your eyes. Is that you, baby, or just a bridge down to the sky?
Special concerts. These stories are coming up next.
Blue shoe strings and 1,000 telephones manned on red. You know I can get rid of these.
For his second and final performance in Los Angeles, in this set anyway, the boss sang before a sellout crowd of over 6,000 last night at the Shrine Auditorium. It's another full house this evening, we are told. Springsteen is certainly no stranger to sellout crowds. Joining Bruce on stage were singers Jackson Browne and Bonnie Raitt. And at one point during the concert, all three of the entertainers got together for an acoustic set. Okay, the Springsteen concerts raised money for the Christic Institute. That's a Washington-based political watchdog group that's suing the federal government over the Iran-Contra scandal.
From the entertainment capitals of the world, it's Showbiz Today, the CNN Entertainment News Journal, with Bella Shaw in Hollywood and Lauren Sidney in New York. Bruce Springsteen, Bonnie Raitt, and Jackson Browne team up for a liberal cause.
The Christic Institute. As Sanya Kenyon reports, the boss had some company at the Shrine Auditorium.
The cheers greeting Bruce Springsteen made it clear. He is still a respected folk hero, despite a two-year absence from the concert stage.
It sounds a little funny, but it's been a while since I did this, so if you're moved to clap along, please don't. It's gonna mix me up.
If the performer seemed a little nervous, the audience was inclined to lend him support.
So tell me what I see when I look in your eyes. Is that you, baby, or just a breeze down to the sky?
Springsteen joined fellow musicians Bonnie Raitt and Jackson Browne at a benefit for the Christic Institute.
We're all in this together. There's a lot of different issues that are equally important, and the Christic Institute is one that really deserves some attention at the moment and ongoing support.
What do you gotta do to get through?
The Christic Institute, headed by lawyer Daniel Sheehan, was instrumental in getting a settlement for the family of the late nuclear activist Karen Silkwood. It brought a civil suit against Richard Secord and others involved in the Iran-Contra affair.
It's a chance to actually prosecute people for the wrongdoing that we all knew took place.
It was never clear how far the gates to my citadel lay.
What's clear to conservatives is how much they despise this sort of benefit.
It's just a lot of people on the radical fringe left of Hollywood flushing their money right down the old toilette.
Whatever your political orientation, it's hard to doubt the sincerity of these performers.
They know they will find me with my maps and my faith in the distance, moving farther on.
Sandy Kenyon, CNN Entertainment News, Hollywood.